Now, dear students, till now we have discussed the different types of labels and as well as have discussed the scope of the labels. Now, just let's build a very minimalistic schematic so that we can understand in a better way about the hierarchical sheet system in our KiCad software. So, in order to understand this concept, the first thing we need to do is let's just build up a schematic that takes 12 volt as input and converts into 5 volt, also gives 5 volt out to some other peripherals, as well as also power up the MCU with that 5 volt, and should have some indications of the 5 volt power supply, as well as an indication from the MCU. So first of all, let's just add a 2 pin connector over here. Let me write a connector. Let's say I want to add a connector that is 2 pin, that is 1x2, and let's just double click it and let me place over here. This is the connector where we will get 12 volt input, and just let me write some text over here that we will connect over here 12 volt from the outward from the that we will feed 12 volt into our circuit from these two pins. And let's just add an other connector 1x2, which means it has a single row and two pins, and place it over here, and over here we will get 5 volt out that is generated by the power section. So let's just save our work. Now, after we take power from the 12 volt input, we will feed this power into our this power section. In the power section, we will be using regulators to regulate this 12 volt input. So let's go to regulator section. We on the left side, you can see that we are in the regulator sheet, and let me just add over here regulator 7805. Let's just double click it and place it over here, and let's just add capacitors. This unpolarized capacitor over here, add another one, click insert on your board and add another one, and let's just wire it up by clicking on the add wire tool. And place over here, let's just add ground, the schematic. Oh, I just place over here, click insert, place another one, insert, place another one. Let's just wire it up, wire this up over here, and let's connect this one. Let's just save our work. Now you can see that this is just a simple 7805 regulator circuit. Now the next thing is, we will add a hierarchical label over here, and let's just name it as 12 volt in, which means 12 volt input, and let's hit OK, and let's place over here, click R to rotate it, and let me place over here. Similarly, let's add another hierarchical label, click on this sheet, and it will generate 5 volt out. So I will write 5 volt output and hit OK. As you see that this is our output, so let's just click over this output, and this will change its shape. So let's just place over, let me just place over to make it little beautiful. Click over here and add that. Now you can see that we have added two hierarchical labels, 12 volt in and 5 volt output in our regulator sheet. Now the next thing is let's add something in the we are currently in the power. The power is the parent sheet, and we have drawn circuit in our regulator sub sheet, and let's just add some circuit in our indications. So in our indications, let's just add some resistor over here, this resistor, and add an other resistor so that we can add two LEDs, one for indicating that we have 5 volt available in our circuit, and the other should be connected with the pin of the MCU. So just add an LED. Let's click R, place it over here, and place it over here again, click insert and hit R to add an other LED, and let's just make connection with these. Let's just place and drag over here. Let's add another wire over here, and let's add ground to both these. Place over here, click insert, add ground, wire it up. Now I accidentally clicked on the canvas. Just click on this circle, click and make a connection. Similarly, let's click on this and make a connection. So now we have added two resistors with the LEDs. So what next thing is we want to do is just add an hierarchical label over here. Let's just add this is for the 5 volt IND, which means indication, 5 volt indication that we have 5 volt available in our, and let's just place it over here, click on this, hit E, and let's change it to input, click OK, let's just rotate it, and let's connect this with this one. Similarly, add an other hierarchical label, and we want to connect this with the let's just add a global label over here. Let's see what happens if we add a global label. Let's click on this, and let me use over here as MCU LED, and it is input to this. We will connect this in the we'll be using this global label in the MCU circuit. So place it over here, let's wire it up and connect with this. Now we have added in this indication circuit 5 volt IND hierarchical label and a global label with the name MCU LED, and let's just save our work. Now we have, what we have now in the root section, we have this 12 volt input. In the power, we have added some indications in this regulator. We have added a regulator circuit in the regulator sheet, and some indications in the indication sheet. So the next thing is we need to add a microcontroller in our MCU sheet. So let's just click over here, and let's add I want to use Arduino Uno R3. Double click over here, and let's just place it over here, and you can see that let's just add ground, place it over here, and let me wire this. And connect all this ground with this one. Oh, I accidentally placed somewhere else. And now we have connected all these grounds. Now what we need to do, we want to use let's say this pin number 9. Click over here and let me do this. Click over here, double click, and a wire is now connected with the pin number 9. We want to use that, we want to use this pin number 9 so that we can switch on and off an LED. That LED we have placed in our indication sheet with the label MCU LED. So let's just copy this label, go to MCU and let's paste it, and let's place it over here, and let's just click over here, hit M to move and connect with this. Now you can see that we have added a global label over here in the MCU sheet with the name MCU LED, and have added indications with the MCU LED global label in this indication sheet. So let's check if we have used global label over here and have used global label in the MCU sheet, and we have also claimed that the scope of global label makes connection anywhere in the schematic. So you can see that one global label is under the in the subsheet MCU, and it has a parent sheet root, and other global label is in the indication with the parent sheet as power. So let's see if these are connected with one another. Go to this highlight tool and click over here. Now let's, its color has changed. Let's see in the MCU sheet that global label is connected with the our circuit is complete or not. And you can see over here that the color of this pin number 9 has also changed, which means when I highlighted this net, then this pin number 9 of the MCU in the MCU sheet is now connected with this LED D502 circuit in the indication sheet. So we have seen that global labels make connection anywhere in the schematic. So these are the global labels that so the global label helps to make connection anywhere in the schematic. So the next thing is let's add a hierarchical label over here, and let's just name it as MCU 5 volt, and click over here, and let's just place it over here, and let's just add wire and connect to MCU 5 volt. Now in the microcontroller side, we have used global label and a hierarchical label, and let's just save our work. And on the regulator side, we have used these hierarchical labels. In the indication side, we have used a single hierarchical label and an MCU LED global label, and we still need to connect these sheets with one another, and also need to connect these sheets with one another. So in the next video, we will be seeing how we can import these hierarchical pins in our schematic sheet symbol and connect this with one another.